Can you manifest if you suffer from anxiety or depression, and how do you do it? Can you break yourself out of anxiety and depression using manifestation? That's what we're discussing in this episode of Roxy Talks. Stay tuned. What is up, my fellow dreamers and soul searchers? Thank you for joining me here for another episode of Roxy Talks, where we discuss confidence, mindset, manifestation, and more. I'm Roxy Lee. I'm a mindset coach, and I'm here to help you banish your negative thinking and limiting doubts so you can bring love, clarity, and joy into your life. If you'd like to sign up for one-on-one coaching so we can discuss your specific issues, you can sign up at roxytalks.com. We've also got exclusive merch, podcasts, and more. That's all at my website, roxytalks.com, and of course, that link is in the description below. I've also just joined Twitter and TikTok, so you can follow me there and on Instagram and Facebook as well. So the idea of manifesting with anxiety or depression is a big question. I get this question a lot here on YouTube, and I wanted to address it in its own video because this is something I answer pretty much every Mindset Monday as well. The short answer, yes, of course, you can still manifest when you have anxiety or depression, but special focus is going to help you a lot because if you are dealing with chemical situations in your brain, the body that you are inhabiting in this very moment, it might feel very difficult for you to get out of that. Now, before we get into it, make sure you hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell so you never miss an update. And if you're feeling generous, please like and share. That helps us reach as many people as possible, and everyone deserves to know that they are in complete control of their reality. Now, before we get too far into this, let me just say I am not a doctor. Please do not use this to diagnose yourself or do anything without discussing it with your doctor if you have one. Now, this topic is pretty controversial because I've seen a lot of stuff in the law of attraction community. Some people say that depression and anxiety are immovable. This is something you have. This is here permanently. You're just going to have to deal with it. Other people say it is just a condition. It is just a circumstance, and circumstances are irrelevant, and we are able to outmanifest them with the correct focus. My opinion is somewhere in the middle. Do I believe that your depression is real in the body you're in? Absolutely. Do I experience these things myself? Yes, 100%. However, I also must believe that circumstances don't matter and that there are no limitations on us and that anything is possible. So, in that respect, I have to say that yes, it is possible to get out of anxiety and depression using manifestation or using your mental focus. Now, again, I'm not a doctor. I cannot speak about medication and things like this. Obviously, I do not advise going off your medications. That's not anything having to do with what I'm talking about here. But just know that it is your mental focus and your overall awareness that is perpetuating your world. That is inescapable. That is what being a human being is all about. That's what planet Earth is. It's our perception and realization and conception of energy in our bandwidth of perception on planet Earth. It is us viewing what we're looking at that populates it into our world. If you'd like to look more into this, look into quantum physics. Some stuff I suggest are David Wilcock videos on the Gaia Network. PBS also has some really great videos on quantum physics. I like to watch that kind of stuff because I like to try to understand what's going on planet Earth so that I can use it to my favor. That's basically what manifestation is, right? If we're all energy, you're energy, I'm energy, money's energy, feelings are energy, experiences are energy, then if I can learn how energy behaves, then I can manipulate it, right? If everything is energy, nothing is what it seems, and it is my awareness of my very world that perpetuates it in my reality, and the way that I entertain things in my mind is the way they show up in my world, then I'm gonna be super on top of the way that I entertain things in my mind. Because that's where my power lies as a human being. It's in the perception, it's in the awareness, it's in the concept of it. Me, I decide what things are in my world, and that's what they have to be. I don't know why. Doesn't necessarily make sense, but that's just what they say happens on this planet. So if that's what's happening on this planet, let me take over where I can. Now, we are all manifesting in every single moment of every single day. Again, it is our awareness that keeps our world around us. So right now, I'm manifesting the very walls around me. I'm manifesting the air in my lungs and the blood in my veins. So are you. Every single moment of your life is a manifestation. So you are always doing it. You can't be good or bad at it. You can't do it sometimes, not other times. It is always happening. It never stops. It never shuts off, okay? So this is why you can feel any range of emotion and still get your manifestation, because we are feeling stuff all throughout the day, right? We go on roller coaster rides. Sometimes we feel amazing. Sometimes we feel like shit. Sometimes we feel mediocre. Sometimes we feel nothing. doesn't matter, right? Things still happen. The world still continues. So it is not necessarily our feelings that perpetuate. It's our awareness. It's our concept. It's the overall communication that we are sending out to whatever it is that's fulfilling this world, whatever it is that's bringing these things to our awareness in the physical reality. We are sending off the message. We are deciding what that is. We are deciding what comes to us based on the images, the ideas, the concepts that we hold in our mind, okay? Do the feelings matter? Yes, they matter because they inform the thoughts. But at the end of the day, it's the combination of all of the things, your awareness, your feelings, your ideas, your beliefs, your overall communication. What are you saying at the end of the day? Where's your truth at? That's what manifests. So in essence, I can be depressed about one subject or one thing and still know that things are working out for me in other areas. Or I can be depressed about all things in general and think nothing works out for me. I can be positive about the world at large for the most part, but expect things to not work out for me, and they won't. But I can also be as sad as I want to or as mad as I want to and still know that my manifestations are happening no matter what, because this is all a manifestation. So I can't impede the process. I literally couldn't not manifest if I tried. There's no way. I'd have to die. And then I don't know what happens after that. Might have to come back here and do all this shit over again. My overall awareness of what the world is and how it works is what I experience. So in theory, if you can feel what you feel, anxious, depressed, or whatever, and still keep your mind in the idea that no matter how I feel, I still get what I want, you will still get what you want. You can be depressed and still manifest. They are not mutually exclusive. However, if you can begin to separate out the way you feel from the way you think, you can distance yourself from anxiety and depression. You can begin manifesting a version of yourself that does not have these things, that is completely happy, healthy, whole in body and mind, that feels amazing every day, that lives life to the fullest, that keeps their thoughts focused and disciplined and doesn't allow the feelings of the body or the 3D world to affect what they do up here. So if you are feeling depressed or anxious, this is your body processing the stresses you're putting on it with your mind. So start mantras, start affirmations, start trying to brainwash yourself into thinking things are okay. When I notice myself slipping into panic or anxiety, that just like, oh, feeling where it's just rising. Actually, today, I'll be honest, today I had anxiety all day long and I had to talk myself off the ledge. I had to keep myself calm and self-soothe. Sometimes all that goes through my mind when I'm going through those moments is just, it's fine. I'm fine. Everything's okay. It's all okay. It's all good. It's very important that I do not let my thoughts go with the emotions. If my body has to process anxiety or fear or worry or depression or doubt or anger or sadness or whatever, if my body has to process it, I allow my body to process it. Just like when we have to throw up. I hate throwing up and I will like put it off for as long as possible because I don't know why I feel like that's gonna be better. I just don't wanna throw up. When we know, when you let the body purge, it feels much better. So if your body has anxiety, if you've been stressing it out with your thoughts, let it feel what it needs to feel. But we keep our thoughts under lock and key. We are very tight up here. Everything's fine. It's all good. Even just no. Sing a song in your head. Just like yesterday's video, I'll link above, we wanna scooch out the stuff that doesn't work. Because what happens when we have depression and anxiety, it's that we're allowing the thoughts to join the feelings party. And we wanna keep our thoughts away from negative feelings. We wanna keep our thoughts away from attaching meaning to those feelings and attaching ideas and what's this and what's that and what if this and now what if this and what if that now. The thoughts add momentum. The thoughts take off. The thoughts take us 20 miles down anxiety road. We want to stay on the main road. If I can feel anxiety or panic or depression or anything like that, and let my body feel it and not spiral on what ifs and how comes and why this and whens and not me's and why not the all that stuff. If I can prevent myself from doing that, then once I have purged that feeling, that sadness, that anger, that worry, the stress, the fear, the anxiety, whatever, once I process that in my body, two things. Because I didn't allow my thoughts to take me 20 miles down anxiety road, now I have a much shorter recovery period. I don't have to go all the way back down because I didn't burn the whole house down because of one bad thought or one bad day. So I've shortened the length of time that I'm gonna have panic or depression because I'm not allowing my thoughts to make it worse, frankly, to add more time, weight, meaning, panic, depression, whatever. We're not letting the thoughts add to the problem. And because we have left our thoughts at, it's fine, everything is fine, it's all good, I'm okay. When we are done processing the emotions, we've left our thoughts at everything is okay. And that's where we pick back up. Everything is fine. Great. Great. If you can be at everything is fine for everything in your life, if your baseline, your bottom rung is fine, we're fine or better on every subject in our lives, your life will work out for you and everything will go the way you want it to. So I want you to comment down below, I am okay, everything is fine. I am okay, everything is fine. This is going to be a reminder to you when you are experiencing panic or worry or fear or depression that you don't have to stay there. Don't let your thoughts add to the problem. Don't let them add to the momentum. Keep your thoughts tight and safe and secure. I am okay and everything is fine. And that will become your reality. So if you'd like help getting into the mindset where you can keep your thoughts focused and in line, you can download my 30 Days of Alignment Challenge. It is completely free and it is what helped me change my thinking and ultimately my life. That link is in the description below. You can also join my Facebook group, Black Moon Society. It's a great community for like-minded people who are helping each other in manifestation. And of course, you can sign up for one-on-one coaching so we can discuss exactly how you can get out of your depression and anxiety cycles. You can sign up for one-on-one coaching at my website, RoxyTalks.com. We've also got exclusive merch, podcasts, and more. That's all at my website, RoxyTalks.com. And of course, that link is in the description below. I'm also on Twitter and TikTok officially now, so you can follow me on social media, Instagram and Facebook as well. Here on the Roxy Talks channel, I go live every Monday at noon-ish PST for Q&A. And I've got brand new videos out every Tuesday through Friday. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell notification so you never miss an update. And if you're feeling generous, please like and share. That helps us reach as many people as possible and everyone deserves to know that they are in complete control of their reality. We're all raising our vibrations together. You have the power. I believe in you.